In this video, we will discuss about the characteristics of the individuals that have been evolved along the lineage of human evolution. In the previous video, we have discussed or we have a look of brief look over the lineage of the human evolution. We have a look over the flow chart of the human evolution, where they were starting from the order Primata, and from order Primata how they have developed up to the Homo erectus or the modern man Homo sapiens. Now we will discuss about the characteristics of certain individuals that have been evolved, or the characteristics of that individuals which we are knowing now. Now, first we will start with the characteristic of the Dryopithecus. This Dryopithecus has been evolved from the Procaucil, and that Procaucil has been evolved from the Propleopithecus and Egyptopithecus. So, we will discuss some of the characteristics of the Dryopithecus. These Dryopithecus are considered as the common ancestors of the humans as well as of the apes. Common ancestors of the two classes, or we can say that the common ancestors of two families, that is, one is Pongidae and another one Hominidae. The class Pongidae, it involves three types of individuals, that is, or three types of genera, that is orangutan, chimpanzee and gorilla. Orangutan were of smaller size and they were human like somewhat, and gorillas, they were having they were also somewhat human like, but they were having the bent type of posture. And they had spent most of their time on land. And when we were talking about the chimpanzees, we have seen that how the chimpanzees and the modern man, that is the human beings or the Homo sapiens, they have been evolved from the common origin. And we have also seen some proofs that the DNA, the structure of the DNA, the structure of the DNA of chimpanzee as well as of the man, they both resemble with each other, and they differs only by 1.27% in their nucleotide sequences. And one more proof we have seen, the structure of the hemoglobin. The hemoglobin structure has also been differentiated only by single amino acid. So, these were some characteristics of the chimpanzees, which shows that the human beings and the chimpanzees were having the common type of origin. And human beings, or the next class, that is Hominidae, it involves only one living species, that is modern man, or we can say that the Homo sapiens. So, this Dryopithecus, these were considered as the common ancestors of the family, class Pongidae as well as the Hominidae. First point or first character, common ancestors of class Pongidae and Hominidae. The second, the fossils of the Dryopithecus has been excavated from the Bilaspur, or from the state Himachal Pradesh in India. Fossils of Dryopithecus excavated from Bilaspur, state Himachal Pradesh, in India. Now, the third character, that is the Dryopithecus, they were more ape-like. These were more ape-like, and due to or because they were more ape-like, they were having dense growth of hairs like apes, and also stiff growth like humans. We said in the third point that they were more ape-like. तो अगर ape like है तो they should show some characters resembling to the ape. So this is the character, the presence of dense hairs over their body. It shows that they were ape like and their hair growth was the stiff type. This shows that they were man like. So it fulfills our first character, that it shows the characteristics or it is the common ancestor of the Hominidae and the Pongidae. The fifth character, they walked like gorillas. They walked like gorillas. How gorilla used to walk? They have a bent type of posture like this. They have a bent type of posture. So they used to bend forward and they used to move like this. So they were having, so they walked like gorillas and have bent posture, or we can say that, and have forwarded bent posture. In the forward situation or in the forward direction, they used to bend, and afterwards they used to walk. So they have forwarded bent posture for walking. So these are the certain characteristics of the Dryopithecus, and it is estimated that Dryopithecus have been evolved around 20 to 25 million years ago. 20 to 25 million years ago, Dryopithecus has been evolved, and they were considered as the common ancestors of both the class Pongidae as well as the Hominidae. What was the second character? The fossils of the Dryopithecus that which were excavated from the Bilaspur from district Himachal Pradesh, and they shows the more, or they were having more characters of the apes, and though they were having, or because they were having the more characters of apes, their whole body was covered by the dense growth of hairs, and along with the dense growth of hairs, their hair growth was also stiff. This shows the characteristics of the human beings, and they also walk like gorillas with forwarded bent posture or with the bent type of posture. So these were the some characteristics of Dryopithecus. First one. The second one that we are going to discuss is about Ramapithecus and Kenyapithecus. Ramapithecus and Kenyapithecus. It is estimated that these both have been evolved around 15 million years ago. 15 million years ago, Ramapithecus and Kenyapithecus has been evolved. The first character that the fossils of Ramapithecus has been excavated from Shivalik hills of Himalayas. Remember this Shivalik hills of Himalayas, because questions are generally asked over this term, that where the fossils of Ramapithecus has been found, or from where the fossils of Ramapithecus have been excavated. So the answer will be the Shivalik hills of Himalayas, and these were excavated by Levice. The scientist's name was Levice. He excavated the fossils of the Ramapithecus. And Kenyapithecus fossils of Kenyapithecus has been excavated from Kenya. As the name suggests, Kenyapithecus, so their fossils have been excavated from Kenya by Leakey. The scientist's name was Leakey. Also remember this, the scientist's name Leakey, who discovered the fossils of Kenyapithecus. Now, the third character is that we said that Ramapithecus and Kenyapithecus have been evolved around 15 million years ago. But when we examined the fossils of Ramapithecus, it is estimated that the Ramapithecus were somewhat older than the Kenyapithecus. Though they both, their fossils were excavated at the same time, and they both were evolved also at the same time. But there is some type of time gap between their origin or between their evolution. So it is considered that the Ramapithecus were somewhat older than the Kenyapithecus. Ramapithecus were somewhat older than the Kenyapithecus, and both of these were Rama and Kenyapithecus, both of these were man-like. These were man-like, and though they were men-like, or they were having the characters of the men, so they have erect posture. They were Ramapithecus or Kenyapithecus were men-like, so they were having the erect posture. And these were the first individuals who were having the erect type of postures. They were not like Dryopithecus, who walked like gorillas. They were like human beings, or they were having the characters of the men, which were having the erect posture. They were herbivorous. How do we know that these organisms or these individuals were herbivorous? By knowing the structure of the teeth, or by having the knowledge of about the tooth denture structure, or the structure of the teeth, we can know that the type of food these animals were having, or the habit of food these animals have been adapted. These were herbivorous. So we have, or the scientists have estimated that they were having the small canines. They were not having the large canines that have been found in the carnivorous or in the other animals. They were having small canines, and all the tooth were having the similar type of size. They were having the similar size. No other tooth was somewhat pointed or increased in the size. So by this we know that, or by knowing the structure of the tooth, or by knowing the denture structure, we can know the food habit of the individual. So these were herbivorous and have small canines. So what characters we have discussed in Ramapithecus and Caenapithecus? The first one, that is they have been estimated, or they have been evolved around 15 million years ago. And the fossils of Ramapithecus has been excavated from Shivalik hills of Himalayas by the scientist Levis. And the fossils of Caenapithecus have been excavated by Leakey from Kenya. These both were herbivorous, and they were more man-like. They were having the characters of the men, therefore these animals or these individuals were having the erect posture as that of the men. And though they were evolved in the same time or in the same period, then also there is some time difference between these two. So by estimating their fossils, or by the study of their fossils, we know that the Ramapithecus are quite older than the Caenapithecus. So these were some characteristics of the Ramapithecus and Caenapithecus. The next we are going to discuss is about Australopithecus. This is very important, and questions are generally asked from this Australopithecus characters. Australopithecus. These Australopithecus are also called as African ape man or Southern ape man, also called as African ape man and Southern ape man. And they have been evolved around 5 million years ago. Next character, their fossils has been excavated by Raymond Dart. Fossils were excavated by Raymond Dart. Remember this name also, because questions are mostly asked over this name, that who discovered the fossils of the Australopithecus. And this Raymond Dart discovered, or he found the fossil of the baby Australopithecus. He found the fossils of baby Australopithecus, and he called that baby fossil as Tuang baby, and he called that baby fossil as Tuang baby. Now this Chuang baby or the fossil which has been discovered earlier by Raymond Jarre, now they are called as Australopithecus Africanus. Australopithecus Africanus. And one more thing, that their fossils has been discovered from or has been excavated from Africa. Therefore, their name is also given as African ape men. Their fossils were discovered from Africa. Therefore, they were also called as African ape men. Now, another scientist, that is Donald Johnson. Remember this name also, Donald Johnson. He discovered another fossil of Australopithecus, and he has given the name Lucy. Lucy. He has given the fossils of the, he has discovered the another fossil of Australopithecus, and he has given the name Lucy to that fossil. Now, these are called as Australopithecus efferensis. Australopithecus efferensis, they are called Australopithecus efferensis are those fossils which have been discovered by Donald Johnson, and they were earlier called as Lucy. Now, the another character and the most important is that they started making weapons. This is also one of the important character, that they started making weapons, and their weapons was very specialized, or we can say that their weapons were very sophisticated type. They had attached the pointed type of stones over the tip for hunting purposes. So, the another character is that when they started making weapons and also started hunting. This can also be asked, that which individual in the human evolution lineage started hunting. So, the answer will be Australopithecus. Australopithecus were the individuals who started hunting first. Now, though they started hunting, or though they were efficient hunters, then also they were herbivorous. They were herbivorous. How do we know that they were herbivorous? Obviously, by the kind of food they were eating, obviously by the structure of their tooth or by the structure of their dentines, we know that they were herbivorous, and they were having men-like teeth. Herbivorous and have men-like teeth. Now, their cranial capacity, or we can say that cranial cavity. Cranial cavity, these individuals were having about 600 cubic centimeter, 600 cc, that is 600 cubic centimeter. And these were the most efficient ancestors of the men or ancestors of the Homo sapiens. So they were having, or these were the first who stand erect. These were the first, or Ramapithecus were the first who were having the erect posture, but they could not stand. And these Australopithecus were the first individuals who can stand erect. And also they were having the bipedal locomotion. We'll write some of the characters here. Here we will write. Australopithecus. They were having, or these were the first to have, or first to stand erect. And also first to have bipedal locomotion. They were having the bipedal locomotion. And so these organisms or these individuals were having the bipedal locomotion. This shows that they were also having the lumbar vertebrae, because that lumbar vertebrae is only responsible for the bipedal locomotion. So they were also having lumbar vertebrae, and their number was more than 10 present man. Having lumbar vertebrae, because, and due to this lumbar vertebrae, they can perform the bipedal locomotion. By some fossils, the scientists have estimated that these Australopithecus africanus, these were carnivorous. And these Australopithecus efferensis, these were herbivorous. But combinedly, we have talked that Australopithecus were herbivorous. It is estimated by some of the fossils of Australopithecus africanus, by their tooth structure. Their tooth structure were having long canines. So this shows that these animals were carnivorous and these efferences were totally herbivorous. But combinedly we said that Australopithecus were herbivorous individuals, because they were having their tooth structure resembling to the men. They were not having the long canine or the sharp canine type of tooth. And here they were having the bipedal type of locomotion because of the presence of lumbar vertebrae that were present in men. And the some more species of Australopithecus has been evolved or has been discovered. They were Australopithecus ramidus, Australopithecus boisei. These Australopithecus boisei, they were nut crackers. They used to crack the nuts and they used the nuts as their food material. The third one is Australopithecus robustus. And the fourth one, Australopithecus ethiopicus. These were the four more species of the Australopithecus that have been discovered. So what were the characteristics we have seen? That first one, they were also called as African ape man and the southern ape man, because their fossils have been discovered from Africa by Raymond Dart. Therefore, they were also given the name African ape men. Remember the name of scientist Raymond Dart. He had discovered the fossils of Australopithecus, and the first fossil he had discovered was in the form of baby of the Australopithecus, was in the form of fossil baby of Australopithecus, and he termed that fossil as Tuang baby. And now that Tuang baby is called as Australopithecus africanus. Another scientist, Donald Johnson, he had also discovered the fossil of Australopithecus and given the name of Lucy. And now that fossil Lucy is called as Australopithecus efferensis. And by some fossils, it has been estimated that Australopithecus africanus were carnivorous and Australopithecus efferensis were herbivorous. But combinedly, we have talked that these were herbivorous in animals. And they were having the cranial capacity of 600 cubic centimeter or 600 cc. Now, the Australopithecus, these were the first individuals to stand erect. They were having the stand posture like men. And how they were having the bipedal locomotion? Because of the presence of lumbar vertebrae in their vertebral column, they were able to have the bipedal locomotion. That is, they used their hind limbs for the movement. And some more varieties or the species of Australopithecus have been discovered. They were Australopithecus ramidus, Australopithecus boisei, that were also called as nutcracker because they used nuts as their food material. The next one is Australopithecus robustus, and the fourth one is Australopithecus ethiopicus. Next, we will discuss about the characteristics of Homo habilis.